everyone, it's Carly and welcome here back to my channel and welcome to my summer favorites. It's been a while since I've done a favorites video, and even though it is at the end of July, I could do kind of a monthly favorite because some of these are very new to me. I figured I would just put it all together into a favorites video for the summer. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you do enjoy summer favorites and sit down chatty videos, give the video a huge thumbs up and subscribe if you're new. I would love to have you here on my channel for the next video, and let's get into it. I'm gonna start off in the beauty and like face category. The first thing I have is this Ulta Beauty Bronze Glow Self-Tanning Drops. And these are actually for your face, and I love them. I have been a big fan of the Ulta Beauty Self-Tanning Mousse for all over your body. But just recently in the summer, I decided to add in a self-tanning drop so that I could have my face kind of tan as well as my body. And these are so good. I love putting this about like 2 times a week. I'll put this into my skincare routine, and I'll wake up in the morning and it's like my skin tone is so even. It's like I have like a little bit of makeup on. It's just a nice way to even out your skin tone, especially in the summer, and just add like a nice glow and tan. There's a little bit of a smell to it, but it's not too bad. And I have like pretty sensitive skin. It's not super sensitive, but I was always worried about like incorporating something like this, like a self-tanner to my face, because I thought I would break out more or something like that. But honestly, like my skin has never been better, and so I felt comfortable adding this. And it really hasn't freaked out my skin. My skin has stayed the same, and no like irritation or breakouts or anything like that has happened. So this is a great option if you're looking for an easy, affordable way to tan your face. Like I said, I put it on at night, I wake up in the morning, and it's glowy and all done for me, and I just love it. I'll have everything linked down below if you guys would like to shop some of my favorites. So now we can continue on to my next face favorite, which is actually what I use for my primer. So after I do my self-tanning drops, I'll go in to start my makeup, and I love to prime with this L'Oreal Paris True Match Lumi Glotion. And I shared this on, I believe, my Instagram. Yes, I did like a Q&A, and this is one of my top favorite products. This summer I've been really focusing on my skin and just wanting like nice, glowy, hydrated looking skin. So this is something that I've definitely incorporated into my makeup that has helped me achieve this glowy, bronzy look for the summer. So I just put a little bit on my beauty blender, and I put that on all over my skin. I don't know if technically this is supposed to be like a primer. I feel like primers don't really do too much for my skin, but I love adding something like this that's gonna add like a nice sheen and glow to my skin. Again, it's not, I have a hair. It's not glittery by any means, but it's just nice and glowy. I want my foundation to just glow and beam in the summer, and so in order to get that, I add this before my foundation, and it just works amazing. I haven't tried to use it like in place of my highlighter, like maybe a cream highlighter. I haven't done that just because I don't know, I don't feel like the most comfortable with that. I don't want it to move my foundation at all. So I'm not sure how it works on top of foundation, but underneath it's stunning and it's beautiful. And I actually got this idea a couple weeks back when I got my makeup done. She didn't use this one exactly. I will leave a link to the exact one that she used, but it was from L'Oreal. And I went out and tried to find it, and I couldn't find it, and I didn't want to buy it online. I wanted something like right then and there. And so I found this one and tried it, and I actually love it. But the one that she used on me was like 10 times highlighted. So anyway, just keep that in mind. As I mentioned, the one that she used will be down below, and that is like stunning, gorgeous. I think I'm still gonna purchase that one because I do really love it. But this one's like a nice subtle glow. So it's kind of a couple options there for you guys. But yeah, I absolutely love this, and it has been my top makeup product of the summer, and I feel like even in the winter your skin is a little dry and dull, I still feel like this would be great. I kind of went a little bit out of order, but one of the products that I use as well to achieve this like glowy foundation look is actually this plant squalene oil from Naturium, and I love this. I always wanted to use squalene oil. I've heard a lot of things about it. I know that there's a couple different brands that use it, and I've really been into Naturium, and so when they put out theirs, I was so excited. I had to snatch it up, and it's honestly honestly amazing. It's really good for hydration and like evening out your skin tone. It's just gonna help your skin look like it has a healthier complexion overall, which is what I really love. Especially in the summer when I'm not wearing a ton of makeup, I just want my skin to look and feel its best. So the squalene oil is amazing. I use it at night, just as any other serum that you would use in your skincare routine. But another way that I also love to use it, I actually started doing this for the first time when we were on our little vacation in St. George. After I was done out of the pool, I showered, I was getting ready, we were going to dinner, and I didn't want to put a ton of makeup on, so I ended up just putting this on my skin and then highlighter over it and like my blush, and it was amazing. I only put a little bit because this particular one does make me look like oily, not in like a bad sense, but it's like an oil for the first little bit, and then it like calms down and seeps into your skin. But for the first little bit, having that like nice oil dewy look, like I love that. And so it's just a fun way to also incorporate this into your makeup. Again, I probably wouldn't do that every single time I wear my makeup, but on a trip or something, after you go to the pool and you're going to dinner and you're already like sun-kissed and have like a little bit of redness because you've been out, it's just nice to put this on as like a little glowy tint to your skin. So anyway, that's just how I've used it. But other than that, I just use it, as I said, on top of serums, after I cleanse, all of that in my normal nighttime skincare routine. So it's been a huge favorite of mine. Okay, my last beauty favorite is actually this NARS Orgasm, the Illuminating Loose Powder. And this is stunning. So my sister, I'm not gonna open it yet because it gets a little bit messy with these loose powders, but my sister actually gave me like a ton of highlighters and stuff that she wasn't using. And this was in there and I never really opened it or played around with it. And I've had them for a little bit. And after a while, I just opened it up to like play with something new. And I fell in love. It is stunning. So again, I'm very scared to show you this. I do not want it to fall on the carpet, but it's exactly like their Orgasm blush, so that gorgeous like rose gold pink, but just in a loose powder formulation. And I use this as my highlighter. I'm wearing it today. It is just a stunning look. I like to go in between a highlighter that has like a little bit of color, and then I'll go to like one that's more gold or silver tinted. But this one again is perfect for those days when you have a little bit of like rosiness to your cheeks, or you want to just add a little bit more color. And it's just been my new favorite way to highlight my face. And I didn't even know that they made them, and so now I'm like obsessed with NARS again. I love it. And I'm telling you, all four of these things help make my makeup gorgeous and stunning for the summer. And I have had so many questions on how I do my makeup, so stay tuned for a fun little IGTV video that I'm gonna do on my Instagram, just because my makeup really like is low maintenance. I feel like in the summer it's hot, I'm sweaty, I have things to do, or I just don't want to like have to spend a ton of time on my makeup. But I feel like you can still have these key products that really help you achieve like a put together look. So if you're not following me on Instagram, go ahead and follow me there. I'll have it linked down below if you would like to. And yeah, these four things have really saved my face during the summer. Moving on to hair care, I only have one product just because I haven't really changed up my hair care too much. I'm trying to grow out my hair, which I'm actually really excited about. I haven't had long hair, I think, since, it's been a couple years. I did have extensions a couple years back, but now I'm trying to just like be natural and grow it out, and it's like I feel like I'm trying to pull it every day because I just want it to come out. I've been having fun slowly like incorporating new products into my hair, and so I picked this Kristen Est Soft Shine Beach Wave Spray up at Target, and I love this. This is a new product for me, and I already love it. I have it in my hair today. It is one of those like texturizing sprays that don't leave your hair like crunchy, but have like such a like grit and like volume to it. Like, I don't know if you can like tell with my hair, like it's just very full, and I suffer from flat hair syndrome. My hair is so flat all of the time. I feel like I don't know what's wrong. Like, my hair will not get off of my head. I know that sounds weird, but it's just like slick and straight. And so when I curl my hair, I want it to have like that grittiness, that movement, but also that like soft, shiny hair, because I do want my hair to still be like soft and shiny. And so this has saved the day. It just like gives my hair some fun and movement and playfulness that it really doesn't have otherwise. So this has become my new favorite thing. Moving into fashion, I have just a couple items here and they're basically all the same. This just goes to show how much I really love them. And these are one shoulder tops. I have been living in these all summer long and I don't know why I've never like had them before. I feel like this year they really like stood out to me everywhere I'd go or when I'd shop online, they were all over the place. So I have a couple that are my favorite. The one that I'm wearing today is actually one of my favorites. It has like a little tie here. It's just like such a fun style and they're so easy to throw on. I personally do not wear them with a bra just because I can kind of get away with that. But they're so easy to just like put on a strapless bra if you want to. And yeah, they're just comfy and fun and they look so like feminine and chic and I really love that. So I have this one here which I love and wear all the time and then you guys have seen me in this one as well. This one is from American Eagle and it's a fun like tie-dye which again I love. So having the two together is really fun and then this one here is just a cute little pink one. This one comes with a set like a little pair of shorts. But yeah, like I said, they're just fun and comfy and they're an easy way to put an outfit together. They're like the perfect white tee of the summer, like easy to wear with jeans, you could wear it with a skirt, you can wear it with cute little shorts, like they're perfect sets, all of that. I love them, so I'm glad that I have a couple to keep me through the summer and they're just like the perfect chic look. Next, I'm gonna go into some random items. This one here, again, is a new little favorite of mine, but he means a lot to me. So I recently purchased my second fiddle leaf, which the first one did die on me, which was not great. I did get it, now that I'm thinking about it, I'm pretty sure I did get it in like the winter, and so maybe, I think that's why it didn't work out. I don't know, but I have another one here. I picked it up at Costco, and it already has new leaves. Hold on. Look at its new baby leaves. Are you kidding me? I haven't had this one too long, but I think he's already loving his life. So I put him there in the corner and I haven't moved him. And I watched all these videos on how to care for him and love him. And everybody recommended a, what are these called? Like a soil meter, I think is what it's called. I got this on Amazon, it was like $12. And what you do is you just stick it into your plant and this will tell you if the soil is dry, moist, or wet. And so for my fiddle leaf, I need to wait until he's completely dried out. You can obviously do this with your finger, but I just feel like, I don't know, I would second guess myself and I wouldn't really know. And I don't wanna take any chances at this point. I don't wanna have to buy a new one. I want to just continue to grow this one. So I figured I would just chalk up the $12 and get this. And it's actually so cool. I use it for all of my plants. And again, it just sticks in and it will tell you when it's ready to water. And it's nice because you can have so many different types of plants that need different types of soil needs and know that like this little guy will help them all. So he's been a huge help to me and I hope that I can continue to keep my fiddle leaf alive. So here's to hoping that we can. Another random favorite of mine is my toothbrush. So me and Sebastian went to Target a while ago, I don't know how long now, but we went to Target and we wanted new toothbrushes and we've always just had the normal like manual ones. And I've always heard from my dentist that I should get an electric toothbrush. They're better for you. They're clean your teeth better, all of these things, but I've never really like made the jump. And then of course, being who I am, I saw these ones at Target and they're just so cute. And I think nowadays, like I know I buy for the brand and the packaging, but it's also a really great toothbrush. So spoiler alert, I did get an electric toothbrush and these are the Quip toothbrushes at Target. And they're so cool, they're so sleek. They're like the cutest electric toothbrush. I don't know, I feel like the ones out there like aren't cute and not my favorite and I want this to like be on my counter and it just looks so cute. I got mine in the rose gold pink and I just think it's so cute. Sebastian loves his as well and it's nice. It like vibrates for 2 minutes so you're doing it for the full recommended time and it like changes its little vibrations when you have to change sections and it's just like really helpful and I feel like this has just really helped my teeth feel their cleanest. So it's nice, like every month, I think you pay $5 for like a monthly subscription to get a new head. So it's really nice. It doesn't have like any charging system or anything like that. You just pay for the new head replacement and you're good to go. So if you're looking for a new toothbrush, I would give Quip a try. They are so cute and so fun and just like easy. I don't know, it's just an easy toothbrush. It's not super heavy and bulky. They have a cute little case to go in it if you want. You can like stick it on your mirror. It's just really great. So for my teeth, they are a huge fave. If you've been following me on Instagram, then you will not be surprised at this next favorite, but I had to include one of my favorite books that I've read this summer, and this is Hillary Burton Morgan, The Rural Diaries. And I loved this book. I think I read it in like a week and a half to 2 weeks. Like, it was a very fast read for me. And it's just her life. She lives on a farm with her husband and her two kids. And it's just like so magical and lovely. And it takes you like completely away. I feel like, especially right now in the times that we're living, there's just so much going on. There's so much stress and anxiety and all of these things. And I think the books that we read and the shows that we watch and all of that is like very important, especially right now, to have like a show or a book or something that just takes your mind off of what's going on. And this was so the book for me. Of course, I've been a huge fan of her since One Tree Hill. I mean, I love Peyton Sawyer, so I knew I was gonna love the book, but it just surprised me at how much I just soaked everything in. Like, there's the cutest little sections of her like sharing. I wish I could find a, I should have bookmarked this. Okay, so this is like a good example. So throughout the book, she has like little recipes that she loves to make or that have been passed down from her family. She has like a really cute Halloween and fall like witch's brew. I don't know, there was just so many things when I was reading it that's like, I hope one day I have so many fun traditions that I can pass down to my kids and to my family. Now I wanna live on a farm. It's very scary, but I feel like every day I keep telling Sebastian, I wanna live on a farm. I really wanna go Airbnb at a farm just to try it out and see what it's like. She talks about her garden, which of course hit me really hard because I'm trying to garden. And it was just a really cute book. So it's an easy read. Again, like I said, it took me no time at all just because I was really obsessed with it, but just a fun read, especially for the summer by the pool, at the park, whatever it is. I think you definitely need a good book this summer. Okay, my last favorite is a fun, like a drink favorite, just because it's summer. We're all like having our favorite drinks and all of that. It's not alcoholic. Sorry if I hyped that up, but this is my new favorite thing, and I know I'm the last person on earth to try this. I know. You guys might remember my love for the Starbucks iced vanilla latte, the little pre-made cartons that you can get at the grocery store. I absolutely loved those. I thought it was like in my veins. I drank it all of the time and I didn't think I would ever get over it, and sometimes I still need it. It's so weird, but I don't buy it anymore. The sugar in it is like very disheartening and makes me nervous, so I don't get it. But I did find a new favorite in replace of it, and it's actually inspired by my mom. So she was at my house. Oh, she was watering my garden and plant sitting for me when we went on our little weekend getaway, which was so sweet of her. And she brought her coffee with her so she could have it in the morning, and she actually left it, and it was like not empty, so I decided one day just to drink it, and it was so good. So here's what it is. Again, I know everyone has already had this because I've seen so many like of my favorite influencers drink this in the morning, but it just never occurred to me. So this is the Starbucks iced coffee dark roast. This is the, I already said dark roast. This is the unsweetened, and like I said, it's empty. I mean, there's a tiny bit in there, which is like a crime. I haven't drank that. I fill up my cup with lots of ice, and then I put this in here, and then this is where things get yummy. So this is the Coffee Mate Natural Bliss Sweet Cream. So I know Starbucks is known for like their cold brew and their little sweet cream, and I swear this is exactly the same thing. I just topped my coffee with this creamer and it's so good. So this has no sugar, and I think this only has 5. So this is 5 grams of sugar, so I've cut back a lot. And it's still just so yummy and so sweet. I like sweet coffee just because I'm not really like, I like coffee, but not that much for it to be like black. I know people just drink this plain and it's really yummy, but I like to have a little bit of sweetness, but I don't want it to be too sweet. So this is like the perfect upgrade. And so I'm very proud of myself for getting over it, and now I'm obsessed with this. Sebastian loves it, and I think my only thing, which I used to say this about the vanilla latte, like I just wish they were bigger, because it's just, you think that you can have one of these a week, but when you're both sharing it, it like goes by like 4 days. So that's my only thing that I don't like about it, but it's my new favorite thing in the whole wide world. So if you're looking for an upgrade to your afternoon or morning coffee, I'm telling you there's nothing better than Starbucks iced coffee. And now you can make it at home. So you're saving a little bit of money, and for me, I'm saving all of the sugar, so. So those are all of my summer favorites for you guys. I hope that you enjoyed watching and chatting with me about all things summer and all of my favorites. Let me know if we love any of the same products down below in the comments. Give the video a huge thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you are new, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.